Let's take a look at the process of adding annotation to your drawing. We're going to add several text objects to your title block. It is made up of several mText objects and several text objects. These text tools are located up here on your home tab and on the annotation panel. We have multi-line text, which is mText, and then single line text. So we're going to look at these two tools and add the text to the drawing. But before we do, let's talk about the standard text for our drawing. The standard text size that we're going to use is 1/8 of an inch, 0.125. In this example, you'll notice that the spacing in our title block is 1/4 of an inch, 0.25. To get the text centered vertically between the two horizontal lines, we have to add the spacing below and above the text, which is 1/16 of an inch, 0.0625. As you read your instructions in your handout, it will tell you to set your snap to 0.0625. So as we go through this exercise, this has already been set. Let's take a look at the text again, just to review what we're going to do. We're going to add single line text to the bottom part of the title block, and then we're going to use mText to add the two larger and multi-line text. So let's start the text command. I'm going to zoom in and go up and select single line text. AutoCAD is going to prompt you for the start point, which is the left, lower left corner. So if I position my cursor at this intersection and go over one snap point and up one snap point, that would be the starting point of the text. So I pick that point. AutoCAD prompts me for the height of the text, which is 0.125. It asks me for the rotation angle, which is 0. And then you'll see this little I-beam. If we turn on our cap locks, we could type in the first line, drawn by, and then you want to type in your name, your actual name. And you'll notice the text comes in red because of the layer that the text is being placed on. If I hit enter, AutoCAD will drop down to the next line. But the position of that text does not line up with our horizontal line. So we need to complete the single line text object by hitting enter again, and AutoCAD will end that command. If I hit enter again, I can restart the command, and then I need to pick the base point for that text object. So I'll move down, pick the starting point, use the text height of 0.125, rotation angle of 0, and then I'll type in the instructor's name as shown. Hit enter twice to get out of the command. Now to restart the command, I hit enter, position the cursor where I want to start the text, and then add the text object. Now to add the multi-line text, we're going to use the multi-line tool. So I'll go up and select multi-line, and to add the text with multi-line, I'm going to pick the upper right corner of the box or the upper left corner, and then I'm going to pick the lower right corner. This is going to allow the mText tool to use the spacing of the box to set up the centering. Once I pick those two points, I want to go up to my ribbon. It changed to the text editor contextual ribbon. I want to change the justification to middle center, and then I can type in the top two lines of text as shown. That should say computer-aided technology. department. Hit enter, and you'll notice that it drops down to the next line. So what we want to do is just click outside of the box, and then AutoCAD will add that text. Now the larger text is a quarter of an inch. So I'm going to go up and select M text, pick on the two corners, change the justification to to middle center, and then I'm going to change the text height to 0.25. And then I'm going to type in the placeholder drawing title. Click outside of the editor window, and it saves the text. So make sure when you add your text that you are putting it on the correct layer. You'll notice in this example, I accidentally put it on the viewport layer. So I want to select the text objects and move it to layer title block text. And you'll notice that it turns black. The reason it turns black is we had set up a monochrome plot style using style 1 for the text layer. Okay, let's take a look at the process of duplicating your A size landscape tab to create your B size. We're going to use the drag and drop feature. I'm going to drag this over while holding down the control key to create a copy of the layout. I'm going to change the name of the layout by double clicking on it. We're going to call this B size landscape. B size just refers to the size of the paper. Landscape refers to the orientation. So I've got my B size landscape tab created. And I want to change the paper size from A size to B size. So I'm going to right click on the tab, select my page setup manager, click on modify, and the printer that we're using in this class is the DWG to PDF. Since we're plotting to a PDF file, let's go ahead and set that to the PDF printer. The paper size that we're going to use for this is the ANSI C. Let's go ahead and use the expanded C. This will give us a thinner margin around the edge. And I want to use, we're going to use B size. So let's go down and select the ANSI B expanded, 17 by 11. Click on OK and close. And that will change the sheet. But the problem we have is our title block still is designed for an A size sheet. As you read through your handout, it will tell you that you have to use the stretch command to stretch the title block. The stretch command is located up on your modify panel. When you start the stretch command, it's very important that you read the command line. It says stretch by crossing window or crossing polygon. You cannot stretch by using a normal window. We want to use a crossing window. So I'm going to select the right side of the drawing with my crossing window. Hit enter. AutoCAD is going to prompt me for a base point. And before I pick the base point, I'm going to set my polar tool on, turn that feature on. I'm going to pick a base point, and then I can stretch this title block 6 inches to the right. So I point the cursor to angle 0, type in 6, and hit enter. Now I want to stretch the upper part of the title block 2.5 inches. Restart the stretch command. Draw your crossing window around the top lines, hit enter, pick your base point, and here we want to stretch up 2.5 inches. And then press enter. Okay. Now this title block does not fit the sheet exactly. You'll notice that it extends over the margin. Well, to help us with the centering of this, I'm going to go back to my page setup. And on the area to plot, if we change that to extents, click the option center the plot. We'll let AutoCAD auto center that for us. And now that your B-size layout is centered and ready to go. The next step would be to create your C-size, either from your A-size tab or your B-size tab. If you look in the Module 3 handout, close to the end of the handout, there's title blocks and their dimensions. Use that to help determine the exact size of your C-size layout.